Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know about this video, watch the video till the end. And if you are new to this channel, you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. So today we have a topic with us is called the sum function in the Excel. Now, what is this function about? Sum is like aggregation. Again, this is a math function. So sum is basically an aggregation of couple of numbers that you see. So like this over here, if you see sum, you know, the sum is basically, you know, sum total of all of this kind. I'll try and explain you in the Excel. Let me do that. The sum in Excel is built-in function and which adds all the numbers in the range of cells and it returns the result of the addition. So it is categorized as the math or the trigonometry function in Excel. So the sum function can be used in the as like, you know, the worksheet function, and it can be entered as a part of even the formula in the cell of worksheet. So the sum function will return a sum of the values which are entered as multiple arguments. So a total of 255 individual arguments can be handled by the sum function, and which can include the cell references and the numbers and the ranges, arrays, and even the constants. We'll start writing with is equal to sum, and you have numbers here. So the sum formula accepts the parameters and the arguments. The number is basically a numerical value which you would wish to sum. The number one is required and number two till the number n is optional. You can have to add up to 250 arguments. There's a cell. See the range of the cell which you wish to sum. So the first range of cells, let's say cell 1 to cell 2 is required. Cell 3 to cell 4 and so on and so forth is optional. And there is this thing called returned value. So the sum function in Excel returns the sum of the value supplied. So the return value is basically your numeric value. And then there are constraints. So the sum function has some following constraints while using. The first one is the mapping dimension. The mapping dimensions must be the dimensions of the source of the line item. The resulting line must be some number formatted always. There's no changes to this. Now the sum function sums all the values which are supplied as the argument and up by 250, up to 250 arguments you're allowed to do. Now these arguments supplied in the sum formula can be numbers, arrays, cell references, arrays, constants, and the results of the other functions and formulas. Like, for example, you know, if you do sum of B1 to or B2 to B3, it adds all the numbers which are present from B1 to B3 or B4, as we have in our, I've selected B1 to B5. So it will add up all the numbers that are there in that particular selection. Well, over here, let me just understand the nesting function in this kind of formula. What is the nesting function? See, the Excel is built-in formula and it can be expanded. But if you nest one or more of the function inside some or the other function in a formula, the effect of this nesting function will permit the multiple calculation for taking place in a single worksheet that is taking place. So the nested function, it acts as one of the argument for what we call as the main, you know, you can call that, you know, for doing such nested function, it acts as an argument for the main or the outmost function. Like, for example, let's nest the sum function inside the round function. It'll say is equal to round, and then you open the bracket, you write sum. And then couple of data, let's say you're adding here A1 or A2 to A6. Okay, then comma, let's say you write 3, the parenthesis is missing. So it will round up the number. So Excel will execute the deepest of the innermost function first, and then it will go on the outward part. So for the above formula, the result will be In order to find the sum of the values in a1 to a6 and round this result in three decimal places. So a total of 64 levels of nested functions are permitted in Microsoft Excel 2007, and before this version, only 7 levels of nested functions were allowed to use. So now, how to open the sum function in Excel? See, you can simply enter the desired sum formula in the required cell to attain a return value on the argument. You can either manually open the sum function in the formula bar. You can go here, you can open the sum function. So basically, you can go inside the sum function and open it. To open the sum formula, you can go to the dialog box, and in the math function you have over here, just go down and check the sum function here. You can select that. So there are varied formulas here that are given. Now, to open the sum formula dialog box, you have to do this, or probably you can try out the formula by writing it. Now, when you do this drop down thing, you'll open up with what you select with the sum option, and you will see the screenshot of this kind of formula. Once you click the sum option, the sum function arguments dialog box will open, and where you can put the arguments and attain a return value for Excel sum function, something like this. And that is for all, it's not just for this, any Excel function that you are trying to evaluate. So this kind of dialog box will open up. I have selected sum if by mistake, but this kind of dialog box that will open up, and then you need to evaluate. Now, see, like this, this are the couple of values. I just want to make a sum of this. So either you press Alt is equal to Alt, and there is equal to on your keyboard, you'll get the answer. Or else you can write is equal to sum and then press down all the numbers to get the answer. So see, there is a thing called auto sum option in Excel, and this is the quickest way to add the numbers in a range of the cells to use. The auto sum button, it will automatically enter a sum function in the selected cell. Now, the sum will total one or more than one numbers in the range of the cells. So what we did here, the Alt is equal to command is basically, I'll just delete, Alt is equal to is like, the auto sum that commands on the home tab, and you can use for the keyboard, from the keyboard, Alt and is equal to sign. So you can absolutely make your work really very easier. Now, after this, let's look at some examples of sum functions on Excel, and these sum Excel functions example will help you in exploring the use of the sum function in Excel. The example number one is here that, when the Excel sum formula is written, let's say is equal to sum A2 to, let's say, A3. Once you do that, you get 20.7 as the answer. When the Excel sum formula is written something like this, let's say the same thing, A3, comma, A5, because you have three different numbers that you are adding. Okay, there's no sequence that is going. You'll get 58.8 because it will take up the A3 value, A5 value, and the 45th value, right? So you'll get 58.8. And if you use the roundup function, you can also round up the numbers up to one decimals, and that will be really very good. Now, when the Excel formula is written in this way, the one that we have shown you here, there's a semicolon that is used, right? 135.4. The sum formula can also be used something like this, if there is two set of numbers, let's say 12, 14, 15, 16, and 17. So how will you sum this column and this column? So you'll say sum this column and this one. So you'll get 209.5. See, here it is. So you can sum both of them, okay, in this fashion. Now, in this scenario also, if you want to add over here, let's say 500, so you can do that. So your answer will automatically move up. What are the things things you should remember? See, first is the value error. You know, it occurs when you know the criteria provided by you is a text string which is more than, let's say, 255 characters long. The easiest way for applying the sum function is that you can simply select a cell next to the numbers which you need to add and click on the auto sum on the home tab, and you can press the enter key and then Excel sum formula can be inserted. So that's it for this particular video. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this, please like, comment on this video and subscribe the channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone. Cheers.